Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. The playoffs are raging on without the purple and gold. It just doesn't feel right. And I'm not the only one who feels this way. I know a lot of you out there in Lakers Nation do as well. And LeBron James also is not happy sitting at home. He took to Twitter last night and had this to say about the playoffs and what his plans are moving forward, vowing that this will not happen again. Said, "I can slash will not miss the postseason again for my career. That hurt. Okay, back to watching these games." So LeBron James saying, "I will not miss the postseason for the rest of his career." That's his vow. How possible is that for him? And can he do that staying with your Los Angeles Lakers? That's one thing here. You notice he said he will not miss the postseason again for his career. He didn't say anything about doing it with the Los Angeles Lakers. And that's one of the big question marks this offseason is, what is LeBron going to do? He hits free agency in 2023, which means this next season could be his last with the Lakers. Could he be walking away after this season? He is eligible to sign an extension as of August 4th, and the Lakers are expected to offer him that extension, but will he stay? If he doesn't feel like the Lakers can keep him consistently in the playoffs, maybe he does decide to leave in 2023, which puts that much more importance on what they do in June and July on the trade and free agency market. So what needs to happen here for LeBron in order to fulfill this vow, in order to make the playoffs each season? Well, first and foremost, on the surface, that's not that difficult. It's actually remarkable that the Lakers missed the playoffs, and devastating that they missed the playoffs this season, since now in the NBA with the play-in tournament, you only have to be in the top two-thirds of the league. Only a third of the league doesn't make the playoffs. Yikes. And the Lakers still found a way to miss out and be at home right now watching the postseason instead of actually participating. But nevertheless, in order for LeBron to get back to where he needs to go, wants to go, and says that he will not miss again, the Lakers have a lot of things on their plate this offseason, especially if their hope is that LeBron will sign an extension with them. Now, I've been of the mindset that LeBron, if he does sign that extension in August, probably going to be a 1+1 deal, which means 1 year and then a second year player option that will allow him to hit free agency again in 2024, which is when his son Bronny would conceivably be entering the NBA. And he said many times that he wants to play with him. Again, an admirable goal, but that could lead LeBron to walk away from the Los Angeles Lakers should Bronny get drafted by some other team. So in any event, I think that best case, if LeBron does sign an extension with the Lakers this summer in August, he most likely will do so on a 1+1 deal, which means that the most we would see in terms of guaranteed seasons with the Lakers would be two more, and then he would hit free agency in 2024. I think that is the most likely outcome if he does sign that extension. No guarantee that he will indeed do that. He might opt for free agency in 2023. So for the Lakers this offseason, it's about rebuilding this team around LeBron, around Anthony Davis. Look, 37 years old, he'll be 38 next season. Certainly some question marks regarding injuries, but LeBron, when he's been on the floor, he has shown that he can still get it done. Could have won the scoring title, I think. Opted to not play the final two games of the season rather than gun for that scoring title, but that would have been impressive, winning the scoring title at 37. And I've been saying this for a while. I think that had the Lakers done what we expected them to do coming into the season, and that's be one of the better teams in the Western Conference, LeBron James would have been an MVP candidate this season. How incredible is that? 37 years old, would have been an MVP candidate. He can certainly still get it done. The question is, can they find the right pieces around LeBron James and Anthony Davis to make things work? Understanding that Anthony Davis has a lengthy injury history, LeBron James getting older, suffering more injuries, how do you support them the best way? Clearly, getting Russell Westbrook was not that. That didn't work. So that is priority number one for the Lakers. Figure out what you're going to do with Russell Westbrook. Do you trade him? Do you find a team that's going to give you stuff that is going to help you make the postseason with LeBron James and Anthony Davis that's going to fit better around them? And then from there, if you can't do that, do you look to waive him or buy him out and then stretch that salary? That's another route the Lakers could potentially take, but I think they're going to explore the trade market first and foremost and see what they can get for Russell Westbrook on that $47 million expiring contract, which he's all but certain to pick up. Now, after that, the question becomes role players. Who can you get alongside LeBron James and Anthony Davis that will fit? We saw them find some success with younger players like Austin Reeves, Stanley Johnson, Wenyen Gabriel. Hopefully the Lakers will lean on more of the same, go back to that old formula that we saw in 2020 that worked so well. Find guys who can defend, guys who can hit threes. Those are the players that you put alongside LeBron James and Anthony Davis. Anything else they can do, well, that's just icing on the cake. But you need those two skill sets, floor spacers, defenders, in order to make a team work alongside LeBron James and AD. That's been the formula for success for a long time now, and I'd like to see the Lakers get back to that. But again, LeBron has vowed to not miss the playoffs again for the remainder of his career, however long that is. Maybe it's another 5 years he's got. Who knows? But however long his career is, LeBron is vowing to not miss the playoffs again. Now, will this become something that opposing fans, that Lakers haters joke about like they do LeBron's tweet? It's infamous now from earlier in the season when he said keep that same energy for those who are criticizing the Lakers for being too old this season. We'll see. Hopefully, again, the Lakers come June and July can rebuild this team and make it fit a bit better alongside LeBron James and Anthony Davis and get them back to where they should be. And that is in the postseason. Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below about LeBron's vow to not miss the playoffs again and what it means for the Lakers moving forward. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.